Oklahoma Football 1986 with head coach Barry Switzer is brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood Age for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. By Terrell Remodeling, Oklahoma's number one siding and remodeling company, building for a better Oklahoma. By Champion Renault Jeep, 16 West Memorial Road, where we appreciate your business. And by Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Everybody, and welcome to Oklahoma Football 1986. I'm Robbie Robertson, along with OU head coach Barry Switzer. It was the Oklahoma defense that stepped up and took control this past Saturday against Oklahoma State. Sooners shut out the Cowboys 19-0. 2-0 in Big 8 conference play. Got to like the way that defense played, huh, coach?
You like the way they play every week, Robbie.
Yeah, that's
true. Why coaches always say if they had their druthers, they'd always rather have a great defensive team than an offensive team. And I still think we've got a great offensive football team. You got to give Oklahoma State credit. They played extremely well, especially when we got the ball in four-down zone. We drove the ball the length of the field four different times, but when we got in four-down zone, they made some plays that kept us from probably having an opportunity to score, and made us play percentage to kick the field goal. I think we became a little cautious to set up the field goal a couple times, didn't want to take any chances, but I think they created that philosophy we used at that time.
I talked to Boz after the game, and he was just real happy that the defense was finally glad to do something.
Like to always showcase the defense, yeah. And they were obviously a dominating football team. There are some things that came out of the game I don't like. Our injury situation, we lose a good player on defense. Darrell Reed will probably have to be operated on, and he's an outstanding defensive end. He and Troy Johnson make many, many plays for us in their career so far, and we'll probably lose him. We've got a couple of, we played the second half with three offensive line starters out of the ballgame. People don't realize this, but we lost our two big studs on the right side, Anthony Phillips. Greg Johnson didn't play the second half, and that really hurts our offensive line, not having those two big, massive players in there. They deferred and wanted to have the choice the second half, and we received the ball. They defend the south goal and kick off north, and we get the ball back to the 30-yard line, start our first possession, and we take a drive here and score on this drive. They run the option play, the first play, and we're caught from behind here, blocking scheme. We've got to be able to pick up. They moved around some, and we don't block the center, doesn't block the nose guard here, and we only make a couple yards, but we run the option play right here and get the ball pitched and switch play, and Spencer Tillman gets the first down in the option play, switch blocking scheme, and get the ball for a first down.
Take another look at the 12-yard run by Spencer Tillman on a 3rd-and-3 play from the Sooner 37.
Do a better job of blocking the nose there. Pursuit. And it's a good play with the defensive back right there.
1st-and-10 at the Sooner 49.
Two tights. It's Tillman for 4.
2nd down now.
There's another 4 or 5 yards for the fullback. Lydell Carr.
Pretty good weather conditions.
Oh, great weather. Another 5 or 6 for Lydell.
A lot better than last year, I'll tell you that.
You
second
bet.
4.
Another big run. Lydell, break it. Inside the 20. 19, so we've taken the opening drive and moved the ball right down the field.
Take another look at this 15-yard run by Lydell Carr.
Lydell breaks that tackle.
Takes a couple to get him down.
Takes a few. He's a pretty good man.
1st-and-10 at the Oklahoma State 19.
That play wasn't as good a play we thought it might be.
Lost 2.
Tillman didn't execute well right there, too. And this play makes us have to set up a field goal after this one right here.
Jamel can't get anything.
Throw the ball.
So here comes Tim Lasher. That's a 38-yard field goal he puts through the uprights.
game's over. That's what they used to yell at UCLA, wasn't it? They go score 2 points.
Yeah, people
stand up and say, game's over.
So the Sooners are out in front 3-0, and Todd Thompson kicks off. Barry Sanders on the return.
Hey, Barry, we didn't see much of him yesterday. The little freshman back from Wichita is a pretty good little player for him. Todd Thompson going to kick off again. Into the wind. Kicks this in the out of the end zone.
Cowboys start at their 20, freshman Mike Gundy at quarterback.
Defense, second and six.
Thurman Thomas on the carry, Bosworth on the tackle.
Gundy going to throw. There's Darrell Reed containing. Throwing the flat, Big Hart Lee.
Pick up a 9, first down at the Cowboy 33.
There's Darrell Reed right there. I'm hitting him in the backfield.
Second and 7 now.
I'm going to run the option play, pitch the ball in the option. Dante Jones, 50. Too much speed for him to run options on us now. Hartley drops one there.
So that brings up a 4th down play, and Kerry Cooper punts for Oklahoma State.
Boy, hit that one good. I want to tell you something. We had some terrible field position in the ball game, too. We started inside our 10 or our 10 a bunch in the ball game.
That was a 65-yard punt.
Jamail breaks the tackle right there. Poor. Got to pick up a stunt.
Pick up a 9.
Now right here, we're going to throw the tight end. It's 2nd and 1, and he's going to take a loss right here, 15 yards. Things like this kill a drive. You can't hardly overcome something like this.
And, it's 3rd down now, 3rd and 16.
On the quarterback draw, get a few yards. And we'll punt the ball away. Good punt protection, good punt coverage was a key in the ball game.
Bobby Riley fair catches at the Cowboy 44.
It's the only time Bobby touched it in the ball game was on punts. He never got a pass to him.
And Barry Sanders didn't rush from scrimmage.
Nope. Gundy, Bosworth, Gundy, and linebackers.
Pick up a 2. 3rd and 8 now for the Cowboys.
Ooh. Heat. Comes some heat. See, 40. Darrell Reed makes a play. So we lose really a good player right there. He is some kind of football player.
Take another look at the Oklahoma defense. 13-yard loss.
Tackle. See, he's right around the tackle. Tackle couldn't keep him out. His quickness and speed.
Down he goes. Punt time for the Cowboys. They only did this 10 times.
Kicks the ball away. The guy punted better than his average has been. With Patrick, there's big play right in the kicking game. Get to catch the football. The ball took a swirling wind there, and the ball took a bad drop on him. Big hole, 10 yards. We moved the ball pretty good. Average 5 yards carry, and couldn't score the ball when we get in 4-down zone. I tell you right there, it upsets me right there. Offensive line.
That's a loss of 3 at 2nd and 13 now.
They can run right there. Cumbie makes a play. They have good speed. They can run. And that's why I felt Big Jackson, Keith Jackson, that guy's a great player. They have good speed. Their ability to run is as good as anybody in the league who we'll play against.
This is a
Jamail's
third.
Good protection.
15 play.
Big Keith goes up and takes it.
Brings it down. That's a pickup of 22 yards. First down at the OU 47, leading 3-0 first quarter.
Well, I tell you what, he made 121 yards in line of scrimmage running an offense and rushing option plays.
Mm-hmm.
And that's Keith Spencer Tillman. Pretty good cracks.
Pick up a 7. First down. Tillman again. Pick up a 5. Yeah, you just felt like it was going to explode any minute now.
Well, there's some pretty good cracks in there. You thought maybe we may get it back on the open field.
Mm-hmm. Holloway picks up 3. He give the Sooners a first down at the end of the first quarter. Oklahoma out in front of Oklahoma State, 3-0. We'll be back with the second quarter in just a minute. Second quarter, Oklahoma first and 10 at the Cowboy 30.
Tillman for 5.
Second and 5. Do you know what your average gain on first down was?
It seemed like it was good. Well, it was. I mean, we moved the ball the length of the field twice. We've only had 3 possessions. We've gone the length. The difference is we don't score when you get the ball in 4 down zone. Something happens right here. We run a power play. Probably should have run our offense and run our option game. And here we've got to run both of them. We run Lydell for 4 yards.
3rd and 4.
3rd and 4. Miss a block right there. Good play, but faded 4 because they can run.
Jackson gets Holloway from behind, loss of 2, so...
Holloway's hurt here. He got hurt then. Shoulder bruised, he had to be iced down at the half. And we hit it. Took the loss, so we have to kick the field goal, 6-0. We had 3 possessions and moved the length of field on 2 of them. No touchdowns, we got field goals.
Lasher's 2 for 2, that was a 32-yard field goal, and Thompson kicks off again.
Second quarter. Kick off out of the end zone with the win, and they break, Thurman here, bounces outside, shows his ability. They crack, and he bounces outside in 1st and 10. There's Sonny Brown and Boz can run him down.
Poor Boz was gaining on him, wasn't he?
He runs 4-5 now, Coach.
That's a 40-yard run for Thomas. First down. They don't get much after that.
Loose field position here. Could have made them punt and a win. That's what upset me right here, is that we had a chance to make them stop them and punt and win. We thought that was pass interference on the offense end. Re-Utah it. And that's made it look like Idaho instead of Utah right there.
Stevie Bryan turns it into a loss of 3.
Now, instead of having our field position, say they break because of his run, we get the ball at the 9-yard line. If we'd forced them to punt, stopped them back there, and not had the 40-yard run, we'd have had a little better field position.
Perry picks up 1.
Here's Collins.
Picks up 5, so it's 3rd and 4 now from the 16.
Do a better job there.
Spencer can only pick up 2, so it's 4th and 2. Thompson comes on to punt.
They end up getting good field position out because of their kicking game. We had the wind and didn't kick it very good. And kicked the ball very good all year. Bosworth making the play. Finch, defensive end. Run the option play. Dante Williams in pursuit. Run the draw play. Breaks the tackle there, but there's Mr. Bickers and a few others. You got to punt the ball again.
4th and 4. Cooper averaged almost 42 yards a kick.
Poor field position now.
Yep, start at your 16 again.
Whole second quarter is poor field position. Good pursuit, Oklahoma State, and run the ball. Leonard Jackson, pursuit.
Pick up a 7.
Leon Perry, big strong man, about, 5 or 6?
Yeah, pick up of 8, 1st and 10, at the 31. Perry picks up 6 more. He had better than 100 yards out of that fullback game.
Good. That's what we need. This guy got 121.
Jamel dances around for 10. Take another look at this. Fake to the fullback. Jitterbug.
No one knows what he's doing. See, Gary Bennett in. We've already got player hurt here. He's having to play. Oh, fumble. Had a, 1st and 10. Now we're, 2nd and 16 because of a fumble right here. Bad play on 1st down. Backside.
Loss of 1. Bailey on the tackle. 3rd and 16 now. Going to go to the air.
Drops the ball.
Carl Cavanis. 4th down. Now, suppose now Oklahoma State's beginning to think, we can stop these people gaining some confidence. They started sure their own 14.
With no gain. Gonna try the slant pass. Ooh, look at that, Oski. I don't think they like it in the middle. Takes a courageous back to want to come across here, baby, I promise you.
Boom. Ricky Dixon.
Boz and Dixon and the Vice.
Third and six now.
Good pursuit of defense.
That's Thurman Thomas, who had 67 yards on the day, but you remember 40 of them came on one play. Cooper punts.
How many carries are here? Patrick Collins, great little running here.
15.
Back. So, I mean, 14 carries, he got 20 yards.
Yep.
That's pretty good defense.
Patrick returns this 32 yards. He started the day seventh in the nation in punt returns. This won't hurt his average.
He's a good back.
He said another one later on was open, too, but he slipped.
Protects the ball. You go, Patrick.
From the Cowboy 33.
Oh, it's a male.
Tripped, lost a yard.
Break the seam. There he comes out the wrong way. Well, stops the drive right here. You know, they had some good things happen to them, too. It was right there. It kills this position. We had great field position on a punt return. Great field position. Keith Jackson, big K. Now we're going to kick the field goal. Didn't get the first because we come out the wrong way. We don't get the first right here, so we'll kick the field goal.
Keith Jackson, another fine reception. Pickup of 11.
I'm glad he's a great basketball player because he can jump, can't he?
He can get up there and go get it. Clearing the boards. But it's fourth down, so Lasher comes on to try a 45-yard field goal.
A little bit off to the right here.
Certainly long enough, but just missed it to the right. So the Sooners are still playing with a 6-0 lead. Boom. Richard Reed on the stop of Mitch Nash. Second and 10. Nash again, Darrell Reed on the tackle. Third and 3. Nothing there for Thurman Thomas. Boz gets him. Oklahoma State was forced to punt. Sooners took a play, took the ball, went down on their knee, and that's the way the first half ended. Oklahoma in front of Oklahoma State, 6-0. We'll be back right after this. We're at halftime. Oklahoma out in front of Oklahoma State, 6-0. I imagine the 75,000 sitting down there in Norman's a little confused right now, thinking that they're only 6 points ahead. What kind of adjustments are you thinking about making at halftime?
The reason they're confused is because they expected other, right? Just like I asked the press after the ball game. They're sitting there wanting to know what happened. I said, but did you think we're going to win the big score? He said, yeah. Remember, Lasser shaking his head and everybody shaking their head? You know, that's the attitude everybody takes. You never know what's going to happen in the football game. We've had six possessions the first half. We've taken three of them, got in scoring position. And one of them, Jamail makes a mistake, comes out wrong. They play good defense. We take an opportunity to kick field goals instead of trying to go on fourth down to convert. Maybe we'd scored a touchdown had we done that. But we played percentage football on three possessions we had in four down territory, and we kicked two field goals out of three opportunities. The score is 6-0. Now, if we'd made touchdowns when we'd been down there, what would the score have been? Say 14-0. Hey, everybody's kind of sitting, it's going to be a blowout the second half, things like this. Oklahoma State, I said, and people will not listen to me, Robbie, because they think that I don't mean what I say, and
no,
I've always been a candidate.
Listen to you,
I
Coach.
Said, going into the ball game from looking at all their film, that UCLA and Miami were the only teams I felt like had better athletes than OSU. And after the ball game, hey, Miami's the only team that played better defense. They run too good. When you got players that can run and play with good effort and got coaches doing a good job with them, hey, they can be a good football team. Offensively, they could be still playing out there today and maybe never score on us. But still, they play good defense, and good defense gives any team a chance to win.
Well, that, you know, you look at the offensive side, but on the defensive side, the way Oklahoma State is playing and the way your defense is playing, you have to feel pretty good with a 6-0 lead. I mean,
but anything can happen, Robbie. Any mistake is too much pressure on the defense. We could turn the ball over in a kicking game down there. We could turn it over offensively and give them a scoring opportunity. We did it one time, but we threw them back. Our defense was good enough when they had something good happen for them. Hartley Dykes' controversial pass reception, which was good. All right, if they have an opportunity to score there, they went the other way because of our defensive play. But that's too much pressure on the defense. You need to be able to score. I felt good when it was 9-0. They got to score twice. But at the same time, defense is the key to the ball game, and defense was the key for them. Because if they don't have some good things happen for them, you know, we'll win a bigger score than what it was.
Okay. We're at halftime. Oklahoma out in front, 6-0, getting ready for the third quarter. We'll have it for you in just a minute. We start the third quarter, and Oklahoma State's going to go on offense. They had the option deferred to the second half. Thompson boots it in the end zone. So first and 10 from the Cowboy 20.
Bootleg, rollout, counter pass. Gundy, thought Gundy was going to run the football, but he wanted to throw it. And they run a spin option, wanted to throw the pass, and Gundy gets tackled. Bosworth gets him from behind.
Third and 8.
Now here's we put 5 backs, and they run a trap to Mitch here, and he pops it for a first down. Surprised us we don't have 5 backs. Have 5 backs in the game. We take out our nose guard.
Mitch Nash for 16, first down.
Waggle pass, great play, but Troy Johnson taps the ball away. But of course our pursuit was there. You Vickers and the cornerback, read it good.
Pretty well covered. Take a look at this.
It would probably take a loss on the play here. Troy read it good and drops off with him. I'm surprised Gundy forced this in there because this could have been an interception here.
Again, a couple of red shirts around there.
And should have probably thrown it over everybody.
Dante.
But the play wasn't Dante, Vickers, and Troy Johnson there. Run the option play, no gain.
Richard Reed on the stop. Take another look at some of this defensive play here.
Run a, kind of a freeze option type play. And Boz, Reed, old defensive front.
Forget it. Third down. Third and 10. Gundy to throw.
Great play there. Vickers got to punt the football.
That's a pickup of 6. Not enough for the first down, so Cooper punts. Coach, they threw 20.
Oh, he hits a great punt in the wind.
5 times on the day.
How many?
25. Did you expect them to throw more?
Yeah, some, that's probably their range. Yeah.
All right, Sooners start Perry. First and 10 from their own 11. Perry picks up 3, second 7 now.
Big, strong Leon. He's a load, too.
Pick up a 12. We'll take another look at that. Perry had 39 yards on 11 carries. Better than 3 a pop. That's first down every time, right?
No, I don't like it like that.
What do you want? 6, uh-huh. 7 yards a carry, right?
You bet. Ooh. Now he's going to hit the crack here.
Pitch to Patrick Collins. Pickup of 9.
Jamal Holloway. Came out the second half doing some pretty good things. Move the football down the field right here. First possession.
This is a pickup of 33 yards. Take another look at the option with Jamal Holloway. This is his longest run of the season. 33 yards.
You've been a bunch of little ones, though.
Yeah, sure have.
A bunch of good little ones. Little Carl.
Mark Moore, Melvin Gillum come in there to stop the play after a pickup of 33. So it's first and 10 from the Cowboy 32.
Jamal again. He's taking the ball length of field on him here. First drive, first possession, second half. Jamal's beat up a little bit here.
Yeah. Pick up a 23. Back-to-back plays, 2 plays. He picks up 56 yards.
Good job, Greg Johnson. Greg Johnson just smothers the guy, and we lose him. Jamal.
What was it, a shoulder or knee?
That's bruised shoulder. That's not the knee.
That's a pickup of 23, so now it's first and goal at the 9-yard line.
First and goal at the 9. Ah, come on. Offensive line. Penetration there. Lose when it's there. Perry. Boom.
Pick up a 5 down to the 4-yard line. Third and 4.
This one right here, we got too much penetration.
Collins can pick up one, and here comes Lasher. 20-yarder.
That's percentage, Coach, right there. Go for the touchdown. And
like you said, they got to score twice.
They got to score twice. That's why you do that right there.
Tim Lasher with his third field goal of the day. Oklahoma's out in front 9-0. Thompson kicks it into the end zone. Cowboys start from their 20. Mike Gundy still the quarterback. That's to Thomas for a pickup of 9. Second one. That's first down at the Cowboy 33.
Freeze option. Throw the quick dump.
Keith Brown pick up a 17.
Run reverse for 5 yards. Pretty good play. Defense. Good job, Stevie Bryan.
The only other time Riley's run that was pick up a 43.
Good pursuit defense.
Not on Saturday.
Slant route.
Hartley on the reception, pick up a 7, first down.
They played the trap. They won't go back to that trap again. We've got it this time.
Stevie Bryan stops it for a loss.
Oh, they're going to try to run the reverse. They flip it anyway.
This is a wild play.
Run the tailback reverse, flanker reverse.
We got a little problem.
Well,
here.
Right there, they call. I'm going to tell you something. Right there is what happens. You retaliate. They call that on Meliazo, 42.
Right.
Now, I tell you, I don't know where he showed it again, but no. I'm going to tell you, they initiated it. Yeah, he just shoved him because he shoved him.
Second guy seems to always get caught. We'll take another look at this as Gundy passes to Thomas, but Vickers is there to stop it for a loss of 6. Boy, Vickers has really been playing well. Troy Johnson chasing him.
Loss of 6.
Yeah, loss of 6. That turns it into a second and 16 play now. Incomplete. Third and 16.
We get down.
Troy Johnson.
See, the defense throws him back when backwards now. Good pursuit, good rush. Way to go, Mike Aljo. Troy Johnson, number 80. Player, junior from Houston, Texas.
Fourth down.
Water tower. Old chartreuse water tower over there. Aqua, blue, whatever you want to call it.
Jamal on the option. There he goes again. Pickup of 17. Holloway finished with 97 yards on the day.
All the options he ran, he had 121 yards.
Yeah.
What happens, he, on the passing game, we had that second down and one. We tried to hit Keith Jackson on a play action. He took a big loss.
Took a 15-yard loss.
Patrick, we knew the foot. I mean, this right here, we knew this right here, this series right here killed us here. Had a second down short, and we tried a reverse play. And pick it up right there with Keith Jackson. Overcome it.
Pick up a 14. Take another look at the throw and catch. Jackson had 3 catches for 47 yards.
He had as many as they did, didn't he? They threw the ball a bunch.
Just about. Holloway hit on 3 or 4 for the day.
Pretty good day passing. Only problem, this play. Run that off an option scheme. Good flash.
Bad pitch. Cowboys recover. Sim Drain the third covers the ball. Cowboys at the Sooner 49. Controversial play right here. We'll take another look at it. See if in college football you have to have 1 foot in bounds. So we'll take another look at this. One official said no, it was no good, but then they conferred and it was good. You look and see.
Ooh. He's on the line, Coach.
Ooh.
On the line, Coach. Step on the white, you out. That's the way it is in Norman. I don't know why it is anywhere else, but that's the way it's supposed to be in Norman.
Obviously, it's not that way in Norman.
And I told that official when he came over and told me, he says, he better be. I said, when I look at the film, he better be.
Might spend a little time looking at that today.
Mm-hmm.
Pass intended for Dillard. Incomplete. And Joey O'Donnell comes on and misses a 39-yard field goal attempt. So whether Dykes was in or out, Cowboys don't score, and the Sooners are still working on a shutout heading into the fourth quarter. 9-0. Oklahoma will be back in just a minute. We go to the fourth quarter. Oklahoma in possession.
Earl Johnson, up four.
That was a turned into a first down. So here's Jamel, first and 10.
Good job, Carl Cabanis, whoever that was. Good job.
Jamel close. Nine.
Close to a first. Leon for the first.
First down.
And Jamel Holloway.
Pick up a three.
My left guard got to see that.
Pitch to Tillman.
Good play, the defensive player.
Thompson punts it away.
There you go, Kevin Atkins. That's a super job, Kevin.
Yeah, make
does
the
a
Cowboys.
Great job. Snaps it and first one down the field every time.
Cowboys start from their own six.
All right. Second and six. Let them make too much on that one. Bootleg it. Al Joe, Bosworth in pursuit, boy. There's heat coming.
This is third and 10 now. No. They had a procedure penalty.
Good coverage.
No chance to catch that one. Derek White.
Ricky Dixon, best safety in the conference.
Thompson.
And there's, he slipped.
See, that's the one he was talking about. He said that was open, but he slipped. Whoa, here now.
Look at that. Why don't you throw a flag on us? We throw one on us because Paul Meliazo. Tell you what, fullback ripping right there.
13 yards. Take another look at this from Lydell Carr, who carried 15 times for 67 yards. He was pretty banged up, too, after the game. He took some punishment.
He always gets hurt, but he's, man, he plays better when he hurt. He says he plays better when I'm bleeding.
Wow, what a warrior. First down.
First down.
Pick up a four by Carr. There's three more.
They were off sides right there. Got the first anyway.
Carr picks up three, so now it's first down from the Oklahoma State 19-yard line.
There's a terrible offensive line. Good play by them. Poor play by us. Guard didn't turn out. We talked about it at the half. We lose on the option play right there.
Third and 14 now. Offsetting penalties.
I thought stay in bounds. They said he stepped out. I see that again right there.
Anthony,
he should have stayed in bounds. Anthony,
you
much
have to
field.
Watch it later.
You have to watch it later, but that's a first down. He might have scored. Actually, he's going to score right there if he don't step out of bounds.
So Lasher comes on and hits a 32-yard field goal, and Oklahoma is out in front 12-0 midway through the fourth quarter. Lasher is comes up with the deep onside here.
Oh, good actor. Went down like a shot.
Looper, Curtis Looper. First down at the Cowboy 31. Mitch Nash for about five. Ronnie Williams is now the quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
Pick up a six, so it's first down.
Play Vickers.
To Dillard, the tight end, for four. Second and six now.
Third and one.
Yeah, third and one. That's right.
Third and short. On the wing sweep. Just gets under it for first. Get a measure for first. Dante.
Next one.
Next one.
pass.
They drill him on the slant route.
Intended for Dykes.
Dante Jones, the first one I've ever seen catch. Bosworth and all of them. There's Bos in front of him. Great job, Bos, blocking the last guy. Dante collapses in the end zone for a touchdown defense.
55 yards. On the interception return.
He can't even spin it.
We hadn't had much practice at that. Take another look at it. Ronnie Williams. Dante Jones is right there.
Ronnie's had a problem with that one this year.
Clear sailing down the sideline.
There's Bosworth in front of him here.
There's Bos.
Great job of Bos. Great player, boy.
Gets Williams out of the way, and Dante makes a great move to get in the end zone.
Touchdown. Seat roll. There's a seat roll, and Troy Johnson got a hold of him.
Lasher comes on with a point after. So the defense gets the only touchdown of the day. Oklahoma 19, Oklahoma State nothing. Cowboys in tough position because when Williams comes in the game, everybody knows it's throw, throw, throw. Deep onside again by Lasher.
Ran with a fair catch and finally registered. He can't do that.
First down at the Cowboy 22. Williams to throw. Loses 5. Second and 15 coming up. Clock winding down. Got about less than 3 minutes to go here. About 3 minutes to go, I guess. Thomas picks a, or loses a couple. Now it's third and 17.
Ricky Dixon. Husky.
Ricky Dixon on the interception. So the Sooners have it at the Cowboy 43. Take another look at the interception by Ricky Dixon.
He'll fumble the first play here. He just Hail Mary'd that one straight up.
Yeah.
Bazooka did.
Ricky Dixon, Derek White back there. So there's still time for the offense to put points on the board. Sooners start at the Cowboy 43.
Fumble the football.
Perry fumbles and Cowboys recover. But the Cowboys can't do anything against the Oklahoma offense, Oklahoma defense, and the ball game is over. Coach Switzer and Coach Jones, the final score, Oklahoma 19, Oklahoma State nothing. The Sooners are now 5-1 on the year. They are 2-0 in conference play. From the technical standpoint, it was defense of Oklahoma that won the game and the toe of Tim Lasher, as we see in this week's musical sideline piece. Now, the Sooners are now 5-1 on the year, and before we talk about the next opponent, I wanted to ask you, Coach, in your preparation for Oklahoma State, did they do things differently on defense? Did they throw a lot of different...
They did. They gave us a lot of different pictures. They stunted a lot, gambled a lot, and they were successful with it. I'm disappointed that our offensive line didn't pick up some stunts a little bit better than we did. But you got to give Oklahoma State credit, and they played good, and they were willing to gamble, and we probably only threw four times in the ball game. We probably should have taken a few more shots in the passing game.
Well, you're going to see a lot of the passing game this week as you go on the road to take on Iowa State. Alex Espinosa, Iowa State's all-time leading passer.
Well, he's been there a long time. Given
forever,
a chance to be.
It does seem like it.
I hope we play better than we did last time. We're going to have the same kind of game we had 2 years ago this past week.
No.
You know, 12-10. ESPN called and they won this game on night up there. They don't have any lights, so they can't make us play at 6:30 because they got to bring them in. I said, no deal. We're not going to play in that cold weather at night up there.
Good
and giving them any incentive. So it'll be an afternoon ball game.
They don't have Braswell playing, but they'll probably do some crazy things on defense,
too. Good football team. They're a good football team. They can play pretty good, and their statistics have been pretty good all year long. I don't know I haven't looked at their non-conference schedule. I'm sure it's not that tough, but what are they, 4-2 now?
Mm-hmm, 4-2. Lost to
Colorado's playing pretty good. Colorado had a tough non-conference schedule, but they're playing pretty well in the conference right now.
Okay, does your preparation, is there a big difference in preparing for a passing team like Iowa State, as far as what you want to do defensively?
No, we'll do the same things we've been doing every week. We'll try to get them in third and longs and play five defensive backs and play the same schemes we always have. The same thing as for Oklahoma State this past week. We play our basic schemes, and hopefully we can play five backs in the ballgame.
Real quick, who would take Darryl Reed's place?
Well, we'll probably move Dillon to that position, Richard Dillon over there from linebacker, mm-hmm. and work him. Plus, we've got Mantle and the other ends to work here, but we've got to get him over there to give us some depth and playing time there, too.
Okay, thanks, Coach. Congratulations, 19-0 over the Oklahoma State Cowboys. OU now 5-1 overall, but more importantly, they are 2-0 in conference play, still looking for that Big 8 Conference Championship. Thanks for being with us here on Oklahoma Football 1986. For Barry Switzer and the Oklahoma Sooners, I'm Robbie Robertson.
Goodbye
everybody.